Thursday evening. Welcome to Wind Down Yoga. Spend the next hour together just letting go of the day, focusing on some nice deep breathing, calming the mind, calming the body. So let's make yourself nice and comfortable and lie back on our mat. Let your arms rest at your sides, palms to the sky. Let's close our eyes and start to breathe deeply in through the nose, expanding belly, back, and rib cage as we inhale. And exhaling out through the nose as well. Let's relax our face. Softening our eyes, softening our jaw. Breathing away any tightness in the neck. Breathing from our shoulders to our fingertips. Breathing from our hips to our toes. Breathing from the top of our head all the way down to the tip of our tailbone. Letting our breath make its way in between each segment of our spine. Inhale the arms to the exhale, reach behind. Let's extend out through our fingertips and push out through our heels. And then let your body go soft. Inhale the arms back up. Exhale back down. Pull the right knee to our chest. Flex and point our foot. And then circle the ankle, big toe leading the way. And then let your foot rest. And let's switch the legs. In goes the left, out goes the right. Again, we'll just flex and point our foot. Circling the ankle, big toe leads the way. Now we can bring both knees in. And we'll start with a gentle rock side to side. And then back to neutral. Let's circle our knees, massaging lower back. And we can reverse. And then we'll keep the knees tucked in nice and close to the body. Release them away. And then you draw them in close to the body. And release away. Let's rest our feet back down onto the mat. Go and let your knees fall open, resting the soles of our feet together. Take a few breaths while we're here. And let's bring the knees back together. Stretch the arms out wide to the side, palms open, face to the sky. Let's drop our knees off to the right, keeping our left shoulder pressed down. We can gaze to our left. We'll come back up and let our knees fall left as we gaze to the right. And Let's bring the arms in closer to the body. Feel your shoulders remain pressed into the mat. Turn your toes in slightly. Let's tighten the belly and lift the pelvis off the mat. And just hold on to your bridge. And then start to slowly melt back down. And let's do that again, tightening the belly, slowly lifting away from the mat. And then we can press back down. Once we've made it back down, let's return to that tight hugged position. And ease up. And once more, nice and tight. This time, as we exhale, let's roll the body up. Come into an easy cross-legged position. Let's allow the back of our hands to rest on our knees, palms open, face to the sky. Closing our eyes, we continue to breathe deeply in through the nose, out through the nose. And then let your chin fall to your chest and breathe into the back of your neck. Inhale, lift the head, tip back, open the throat. Again, exhale, draw chin to chest. Inhale, lift the head, tip back, open your throat. Exhale, chin to chest. And inhale, lift it back and open your throat. And then just find your way into that neutral place. Let your hands come together in heart center. Sitting tall, let's turn our eyes to look left. Come back to neutral. We'll turn our eyes to look right. Return to neutral. And again, we'll turn our eyes to look left. Back to center, and let's turn to look right. Return to that neutral place. As we inhale, extend towards the sky. Then as we exhale, let the arms go wide. Let's roll the shoulders from back to front. And we'll make them a little bigger so that more arm gets involved. And then just let your arms extend. Let's open the heart, tip the head back, open the throat. And as we neutralize the spine, bring our hands back to our heart. Place our fingers, push away from the body. And as we reach up, press the palms towards the sky. The arms float all the way back down. Breathe deep. Let's take one more inhale as we are. Exhale as we go soft. And transition onto hands and knees. Whatever way works for you to get to hands and knees. Once there, we've got shoulders over hands, hips over knees, tops of the feet on the mat. Let your navel sink as your tailbone lifts. Lift your head, open your heart, cow. Exhale, let's scoop in and round for cat. Inhale, open for cow. Exhale, round out, cat. Inhale again for cow. And exhale, round out for cat. And then just make your way back to that neutral place. Extending the left leg behind, we push out through left heel. We can add the right arm forward, bringing us into spinal balance. Exhale, lower and switch. Right leg extends and left arm comes forward. Lower forward, switch again. Right arm and left leg extend. And release, and switch once more. And come back to all fours. Now we'll separate the knees while the big toes are touching and push back with the tailbone. Feel your chest drop through your knees, forehead to the mat. Extend out through your fingertips. And feel that stretch from tailbone to top of head. Let's pass the right arm through the left armpit. Bring that arm out and we'll switch, passing left through right. And then bring the arm back out and just push back through your tailbone. Let's keep our palms flat with our fingers wide spread. Tuck our toes and start to build downward facing dog. Letting your head drop through your arms, feeling your rib cage pull closer to your thighs, feeling the back of your shoulder blades drawing down towards the gluteals. We'll walk our dog, really work at stretching the feet up through the calves into the hamstrings. And let's raise our heels and press them down. Try again, we'll raise our heels and press them down. Now let's inhale ourselves into a good strong plank. Got our shoulders over our wrists, eyes looking out, belly button tight, but buttocks is relaxed. Press back up into down dog. Inhale, return to plank. And exhale, down dog. Inhale, forward again into plank. We're going to modify to the knees. And then as we're lowering, elbows are wide. I want you to bring your chest down, then your hips. Now tuck your elbows in. Lengthen the spine. Rise away from the mat into cobra. Exhale, wide with the elbows going down. Elbows tuck in, inhale, rise into cobra. Once more, elbows wide, going down. Elbows tuck in, inhale, rise into cobra. Let's re-tuck the toes and come back up into down dog. Inhale, return to plank. Modify if you'd like or lower in one piece. Elbows wide, chest down, hips down, elbows tuck in. Inhale, rise, cobra. Exhale, tuck toes, downward facing dog. Again, inhale, forward to plank. Exhale as we lower, elbows open, chest down, hips down, elbows in. Inhale, rise, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Let's do a few more walks of our dog. And then raise our heels together. And let them press down. Let's ease back down onto all fours. Once there, we'll sink our navel, lift our tailbone, lift our head, open our heart cow. And then exhale as you round for cat. Do that again. Inhale, open cow. And exhale, round for cat. And then just find your way back to that neutral place. Let's extend the right leg behind as we push out through right heel. And then we'll step the right foot forward. We've got our foot between our hands, our knee over our ankle. Pressing down into right big toe, second toe, let's lift upper body. Adding the arms brings us into crescent moon. As we exhale, fold forward, hands to the mat. Tuck the left toes, lift the left knee. That becomes runner's lunge. Now step the right foot back. Let's press back up into down dog. And then return to all fours. Sink your navel, lift your tailbone, lift your head, open your heart, cow. Exhale, round and scoop for cat. And then we're back to that neutral spine. This time we send the left leg behind and push out through left heel. And then step the left foot forward. Got the foot between the hands, knee over ankle, weight pressing into left, big toe, second toe. Lifting upper body brings us into crescent moon. Exhale, fold forward. Tuck the right toes, lift the right knee. We're back in our lunge. Now let's step the right foot forward. Big toes touch, heels apart. Upper body just melts down. Let's inhale and roll up. Reach to the sky. Exhale to the heart. Inhale to the sky. Exhale to the heart. Once again, inhale to the sky. And this time, exhale, let's fold forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, roll the body up and reach to the sky. Exhale to the heart. Inhale to the sky and exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out and exhale as we sink. Right foot back, left foot back, holding onto plank. Exhale, let's lower elbows wide, chest down, hips down, elbows tuck in. Inhale, rise, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, return to plank. And exhale, down dog. Right foot forward, left foot forward, toes and heels out. Inhale, roll up, reach and touch the sky. Exhale, return to the heart. Inhale again to the sky, exhale, folding forward. Inhale, look out, and exhale as we sink. Left foot back, right foot back, plank. Exhale as we lower, elbows open, chest down, hips down. Elbows tuck in, inhale, rise, cobra, exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, return to plank, and exhale, down dog. Left foot forward, right foot forward, toes and heels out. Inhale, let's roll up. Reach to the sky. And exhale to our heart. Inhale again, touch the sky. And exhale as we fold. Inhale, look out. Exhale, sink deeper. Right foot steps back, holding us in plank, or into runner's lunge, sorry. Now let's push our right heel down and turn our right toes out. Align your left heel with the back of your right heel. Weights in your left big toe, second toe, and we start lifting upper body. And keep our hip bones facing forward, and then we can add the arms overhead. And that takes us into warrior one. Exhale, let your hands come together at heart center. Let's lace our fingers and push our palms away from our body. And then begin to hinge forward and pull your ribs close to your front thigh. Release your hands to the mat. Return to the ball of your right foot. And then push your weight forward onto your left foot, straightening the left leg as we extend our right leg behind us, bringing us into a tripod balance. Let's step the right foot in. Toes touch, heels apart. Inhale, rolling up. Reach and touch the sky. Exhale to the heart. Inhale again to the sky. And exhale as we fold. Inhale, look out. Exhale, sink deeper. Left foot steps back into lunge. Pushing our left heel down, turning our left toes out. Aligning our right heel with the back of our left heel. Keeping right knee over ankle, weight in right big toe, second toe. We lift upper body. Our hips remain square to the front of our mat. And then adding our arms for warrior one. come together, heart center. We'll lace our fingers, and then let's press our palms out. And again, begin to hinge forward, pulling our ribs close to that front thigh. Release hands to the mat. Push the right leg straight as you extend behind you, forming a tripod with your right foot. And then let's step the left foot in. Big toes touch heels apart. We roll up. Reach high to the sky. Exhale into your heart. Inhale again to the sky and exhale, folding forward. Inhale, looking out. And exhale as we sink. Right foot steps back, bringing us into our lunge. And now let's keep our right hand pressed down as we inhale, left arm to the side. And then as we exhale, revolve at the waist. And there's our twisting lunge. Exhale, left hand down inside left foot. Proceed to walk yourself around into a straddle facing the wide edge of our mat. Hands under shoulders, toes straight ahead or turned in slightly. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale as we melt. Letting our head drop. And let the weight of your upper body just hang forward. Bend your knees as much as you need to. Down through the palms, pushing the arms straighter and straighter. From here, let's try lifting our heels so we end up on that big toe knuckle. We'll press our heels back down, really work at spreading your toes wide. And again, let's raise the heels. And then we'll let the heels drop. Inhale, lengthen, look out with our flat back. Add your arms when ready for a nice treadle airplane. And let's inhale as we rise to standing. Once we've made it upright, we can heel toe our feet a little closer together. Toes in, heels out, turn your palms open to the sky. And there's Five Pointed Star. Lower the right arm. It's going to make a big circle up and come back out. Let the left arm lower and make that full circle. Again, right arm lowers and makes the circle. And the left arm lower and make the circle. Good. Now let's lift both hands overhead. Let your palms meet. And then your fingers lace. And we'll press our index fingers together. And let the arms come forward. Feel that deep stretch across the upper back and the back of our shoulders. And then let's reopen. And we're back into our star. Turning your left toes to face the front end of our mat. Align your left heel with your right arch. And then when you feel ready, bend the left knee. Find that place where you've got your body weight equally balanced into both feet. But you can feel the weight in your left foot pressing into left big toe, second toe. Raise the right arm alongside your ear. Extend the left arm a little further out. And as we lift the left, lower the right and let your left palm turn to the sky. And I know while we're here, let's pull left leg straight. And continue to push all the way out through the left palm, feeling the stretch going up the left side of your body. our way back to our five, our neutral position. So we're back to where we started. And to start building triangle weight, we can pull our right hip behind us directly and reach our left arm out as far as we can. And then simply lower the left and lift the right. And feel your body pressing against the imaginary wall. Stretching your right fingers to the sky. Remember your left hand, you can place it anywhere on your left leg, ensuring that your body stays open and flat. And from there, let's bend the right elbow and just press the back of your right hand into your lower back, keeping your right shoulder pointing at the sky. And then let's bend the left knee. And you can either place your left hand on the mat, or you could rest your forearm on your thigh. And just stretch the right arm up, and then let it come right across the right ear. And there's our side angle pose. We'll inhale, lift the right arm. Exhale, let's start to revolve. Return to the ball of your right foot, bringing us into lunge, and then step your right foot back, holding onto your plank. Modify if you'd like. From there, as we lower, the elbows go wide. The chest comes down, the elbows tuck in. Inhale, rise, cobra. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, forward to plank. Let's lift the right foot and press back into three-legged dog. And then we'll step the right foot forward. Step the left foot forward. Toes in, heels out. As we bend our knees and sink our hips, we're going to pull our knees closer together. Lift our ribs away from our thighs. Add the arms alongside our ears. And there's our chair pose. Inhale, let's reach high and touch the sky. Exhale to the heart. Inhale again to the sky and exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out, and exhale as we sink. We'll step our left foot back, bringing us into lunge, and then let's keep our left hand on the mat. Inhale, the right arm out to the side, and as we exhale, revolve at the waist, so our right hand is reaching towards the sky, twisting lunge. Exhale the right hand down inside the right foot and proceed to walk around into your straddle, facing wide edge of mat. We've got toes in, heels out, hands under shoulders, inhale, look out. And then exhale as we fold, let the elbows drop, let the head drop. Press down through the palms, pushing our arms straighter and straighter. Once there, let's bend the knees and think about pulling our tailbone towards the mat. And let's push the leg straight, pushing the arms straight. And try again, bend the knees, pulling that tailbone towards the mat. We'll push the leg straight, push the arm straight. And let's inhale, look out with our flat back. Exhale, add the arms for airplane. And then as we inhale, let's rise from here. And once we're upright, we can heel to our feet a little closer together. Toes in, heels out. Palms open, face to the sky. Five-legged dog. Now let's lower the right, lift the left. back up. Lower the left, lift the right, side bend to your left. And back up. Lower right, lift left, side bend. And back up. Once more, lower left and lift right. And then we're back to that five-point star. Now let's bend the elbows and bring your wrists right into your armpits. Like you've got a glass of water sideways in your hand. You're going to try to pour the water out over your thumbs. While you're doing that, think about expanding and opening your heart. Keep your head back, open your throat. Then we're going to sweep the arms around so the back of our hands come close. Come back and pour the water. Sweep the arms around. And then as you pour the water, and again, sweep the arms around. Now rotate so your palms meet. And then as we bend the elbows, try to bring your elbows and forearms close together. Inhale as we rise. Exhale, return to your star. Now we're ready to turn our right toes to face the right end of our mat. Align your right heel with your left arch. And bend the right knee. Finding that place where body weight is centered equally between the feet. We've got our weight pressing into our right big toe, second toe. Warrior two. Powerful and open. Lift the left arm alongside the left ear. And then start reaching out with the right arm. And as we start lifting the right, we can lower the left, and there's reverse warrior. Now try to pull your right leg straighter and straighter without locking. And there's reverse triangle. Feel the stretch traveling from your right heel all the way out through your palm. And then we'll bring ourselves back to our starting position. For triangle, our left hip starts to pull directly to the left, and our right arm is reaching all the way out in front. Once we can't go any farther in either direction, that's when we can lower the right and lift the left. And feel like your body is being pressed open against that imaginary wall. Remember to keep the shoulder relaxed and the neck relaxed. And then from there, let's bend the left elbow so the back of our left hand presses against our lower back. And we've got that left shoulder pointing to the sky. And then let's bend the right knee. So we can either keep our right forearm on our right thigh, or we could reach that right hand to the mat. And then we'll send the left arm up. Let it come right down alongside the left ear. And there's our side angle pose. We'll inhale the left arm back up. And then as we exhale, let's revolve. Once your hands make it to the mat, return to the ball of your left foot for lunge. Step your right foot back into plank. Modify if you'd like, lowering down, elbows wide, chest down, hips down. Elbows tuck in, inhale, rise, cobra, exhale, tuck toes, downward facing dog. Inhale, return to plank. Lift the left foot and then press back into three-legged dog. We'll step our left foot forward, right foot forward, toes in, heels out, inhale, let's roll up. Reach high to the sky, and then exhale to your heart. Let's bring ourselves into standing mountain pose. let's become very aware of our balance. And find a focal point for our eyes and fix it on that spot. And then feel the abdominals drawing in to support the spine and give us balance. And shift your weight into your left foot. Again, pressing into your left big toe, second toe. We'll bring our right heel close to our left ankle bone and then place your hands together at your heart. When you feel ready, let's lift the foot and place it wherever you'd like, as long as we're not pressing our heel against the side of our knee. And then let's try growing the branches of our tree. Then send the right foot back down, bringing us back into our standing mountain pose. Now we're ready to try the other side. So again, we've got our focal point. We can feel the abdominals lifting and holding as we shift our weight into our right foot. We can place our left heel against our right ankle bone, and then hands at the heart. Lift your toes wherever you can get them to go without pressing against the side of your knee with your heel. And then we can grow the branches of our tree. Doesn't sound like a lot of social distancing going on back there at the ball field. Going to let the branches of your tree lower first. And we're going to place our foot back down, returning us to our standing mountain pose. Let's inhale, touch the sky. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look out. And exhale as we sink. Now let's just cradle our elbows in the palms of our hands. Let our head drop within that frame. Release our hands, step back, right foot, left foot, and return to plank. Now let's keep left shoulder over left wrist, and we'll move into side plank. Modify to the side of your left knee if you'd like. And let's take the right foot and step it across. And then from there, we're simply going to lower down onto the left hip. And let's bend the left knee. Keep the right foot stepped across the bent left leg. And then we'll slide the left hand a little bit further behind us. And try tucking the right arm inside your left thigh. Inhale and just keep lengthening and opening your spine. And let's inhale, reach to the sky. Exhale, let that arm float down. And then we can uncross our legs. Let's come right around onto all fours. We'll step our feet back, bringing us into plank. And now let's keep right shoulder over right wrist and turn to open for side plank. We'll step the left foot forward. And then from there, let's come right down onto the right hip. Bending the right knee. Keep the left foot stepped across the bent right leg. We'll send our right hand a little bit further back. And let's bring that left upper arm and press it against the inner left thigh. Inhale, we're sitting taller and taller. And let's inhale, reach the hand high. And exhale, bring it back down. And we can uncross and come back around on all fours. Let's do our cow stretch, sink our navel, lift our tailbone, lift our head, open our heart. And then exhale as you round out the cat. Try again, inhale, open cow. And exhale, round for cat. And then just make your way back to that neutral place. We're gonna inch the left knee forward behind the left wrist. Use your right hand to guide your left heel across, aim it at that right hip bone. Think about opening left knee to the side of your mat and then inching your right leg a little farther back so that you can ease down as far as you can. And in our pigeon pose, I want you to press down through the top of your right foot. Press that edge of your left pinky toe into the mat. So we have a nice active stretch. We should not feel any discomfort in the left knee. Once we've made it upright, we'll send the left knee back, bringing us back to all fours, and then let's switch. Pull the right knee forward. We're going to use the left hand to guide the right heel across, aiming it at our left hip bone, opening the right knee to the side of the mat, inching our left leg a little further back, and easing down. Again, let's press through the top of the left foot and the outer edge of that right pinky toe. And keep the weight out of your right knee. Inhale, we can start to rise up. And then let's ease the right knee back, returning us to all fours. Now we're ready to separate the knees, touch the big toes, push the tailbone back, and go back into extended child's pose. We'll pass the right arm to the left armpit. Again, sinking down. We can unthread that arm and switch left to right. Let's bring the left arm back out. And then we can walk the hands in closer. And let's lift upper body. Once there, we'll make our way around, have a seat. Let's extend the legs, keep the knees a little bit bent. Hook onto your big toes and then try to pull your ribs closer to your thighs. And then from there, see if you can push your legs a little straighter. And then we can release our toes And slowly come up. Once we're up, let's keep the right leg straight. We'll bend the left knee. And then try to get the heel of your foot close to your sit bones. And we'll want to keep our sit bones on the mat. From there, let's take the right arm and just wrap it around the bent left knee. Inhale, let's sit taller and straighter. And then as we exhale, we're going to turn and look over the left shoulder. Try passing your left hand around so the back of your left hand finds its way to the outside of your right hip. Exhale as we untwist and switch. Left leg goes straight, right knee bends this time. Walking that foot in close, remaining tall. We wrap our left arm around the bent right knee. Inhale, sit a little taller. Exhale, turn and look over your right shoulder. Now we're going to bend both the knees at the same time, and you can put your hands behind your thighs. Start by sitting really straight, and then let's scoop the belly in as we round the back. Drop your chin to your chest. Inhale, let's lift, open, opening the throat, and again exhale, scoop the belly in as we round back. Inhale, lift, we open the throat. And then exhale, scoop around. Now while we've got that scoop, let's extend the arms and we're going to roll down one segment at a time. Once we're down with our arms pressed at our sides, let's turn our toes and our heels out slightly. And then tighten the belly and start to slowly lift away from the mat. So we're back into our bridge. You want to feel this in the gluteals and the hamstrings, not in the knees or the thighs. Now pull the right knee in and stretch your right leg towards the sky. Let's bend the right knee and then we'll switch left knee in. Bend towards the sky. And then we can bend that knee. Continue to press hips a little bit higher. And then try clasping your hands beneath you. We'll walk our shoulder blades closer together. Press your knuckles into the mat. And then let's release our hands and slowly melt back down. And once you made it all the way down, knees to chest. A few rocks from side to side. And then let's circle the knees around and around. And reverse. And then just hold the knees snug to your body. Let's start to open the knees, pressing the soles of our feet closer together. Let your feet rest in your hands and let your heels pull towards your body. And then let's separate the feet. Knees remain bent. We're going to push up with our feet, pull down with our hands. And feel your shoulders and your spine stay relaxed against the mat. But feel some resistance between your hands pulling down and your feet pressing up. then we'll start to extend the legs straighter and wider. And that becomes our lying fan. And let's bring the legs closer together overhead. And think about pulling your toes straight over your head. And then let's ease up, we'll bend the knees. Place your feet back onto the mat. And let's cross our left leg over our right. We'll open the arms wide and let's drop your knees to the right. While they're heading to the right, we're going to keep our left shoulder pressed down. And let's bring the knees back up. We'll change the cross of our legs. And then let your knees fall off. Right shoulder stays pressed. And then we can come back up. And let's uncross. Now let the arms float up. While your fingers are reaching up, I want you to press your shoulders into the mat. And then just let your arms float back down alongside you. Pressing through the back of your hands and opening your shoulders. Let's slide the legs out one at a time. And then once you're all the way straight, I want you to stretch your arms from your shoulders to your fingertips. So feel like you're trying to really just lengthen the whole arm without tensing the rest of your body. And then let's relax the arms and do the same with our legs. Push out through your heels. And then let your legs go soft. And now let's do arms and legs together. And then let it go soft. And we're just going to maintain our nice deep breathing. Letting our breath circulate around the body. Seeking out any spots that remain tense or tight. If you find random thoughts entering, acknowledge their presence and then just send them away. Bringing your mind back to your breath. Feel as if you're floating just above the surface of your mat. joy is not in things, it is in us. True happiness must come from within you. You will find happiness by letting your conscience guide you. Listen to it, follow it. Your conscience is the key to your happiness. Let us send away all of our anxious thoughts and make a conscious decision to live our days with courage, with an open heart and a grateful heart, and a heart filled with hope. Send random acts of kindness simply because. Know that my soul honors your soul. I honor that place in you where the entire universe resides. I honor the light, the love, the truth, the beauty, and the peace within you, because it is also within me. In sharing these things, we are united. We are the same. We are one. Namaste. And you can just begin to wake your body up. May you have a peaceful evening and a good night's sleep. And I will see you.